Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in this video, I want to talk about the Fed's comments last week on interest rates, on inflation, and the market's reaction, even though it's obvious that these market moves that were made right after the Federal Reserve spoke are not going to be sustained. And of course, last week, all the talk was of this dot plot that the Federal Reserve showed everyone with what their thoughts were on rate increases for next year 2022. So we can pull that up here. Now, if we look at this dot plot and see what it's actually saying, there's re these rate hikes are really minimal. So if we take a look at this plot, right here is the levels for 2022, and then we have 2023, and then these last dots are at some point in the future, which is undetermined. So if we take a look at this chart, we have the rate expectations for 2022, 2023, and longer term, which is just some arbitrary guess on where interest rates will be in the future. And so people weren't freaking out about what the longer term interest rates are. Even in 2023, what caused the whole market to go into a frenzy was that in 2022, the federal funds rate would increase to 50 basis points or 0.5%. Now, since the Fed has acknowledged that inflation has run hotter than they've expected, they say, this is their idea of starting to raise rates to combat inflation. Well, it's pretty obvious that raising rates to 50 basis points is not going to do anything to stop inflation, right? If inflation's at 5-6% a year, raising interest rates to 0.5% is not going to do anything. It's really insignificant. Yet despite this, when this plot came out, you saw the dollar rise and bonds rise, which means that the market is expecting that the Fed is going to be able to fight inflation by raising rates. So now let's talk about the Fed's expectations on inflation. I think everyone should take the Federal Reserve's expectations on inflation with a grain of salt. This whole time, the Federal Reserve has been saying this inflation is transitory, it's going to go away, and if it turns out to be higher than expected, we have the tools to deal with that. And the truth is, they do have the tools to deal with it by shrinking the money supply and raising interest rates, but they wouldn't do that because that would cause a total collapse in the economy. Now, to look at how unrealistic the Fed's inflation expectations are, here is a quote from one of the Fed presidents, Bullard, and on his interview with CNBC, he says he's expecting 2.5% inflation next year, and then by the end of 2022, you have 2.5 to 3% inflation. You also have Fed Chair Powell saying it's very, very unlikely the US will see 1970s style inflation. This is when we had double digit inflation for many years in a row. But I think both of these claims don't make any sense. First of all, Bullard claiming that we're only gonna have 2.5 to 3% inflation. For the past 10 years, the CPI, which I do not think captures the true degree that inflation is occurring, over the past 10 years, inflation has been running at 2% a year, according to the CPI. And in 2020, everything shut down and 35% of all the dollars in existence are created. And he expects inflation to only run to pretty much not even increase at all. He thinks that will have no effect and that inflation will stay at around 2-2.5% a year. And to Jerome Powell's claim that it's very, very unlikely that the US will see 1970 style inflation. Well, that may be true if you are using the CPI to measure inflation. But as I've talked about in the channel in the past, if you use other measures of inflation, such as how it was calculated back in the 70s and 80s, you'd see a very different picture on inflation. Here is a source I've showed on this channel before. It is shadowstats.com. I'll put this link down in the description. But what this does is it measures inflation based on how the CPI was calculated back in the 1970s, 1980s, and 1990s. Because it's clear that the CPI, as it's currently constructed, is designed to underestimate inflation. But if you calculate the CPI the same way it was calculated 34 years ago, you'd see a very different picture. If you calculated the CPI that way, over the past 10 years, inflation was running at around 5% a year, and in 2021, we've spiked and we're now over 8% inflation. So if you do use the same calculations based on the 1970s and 1980s, we may not be very far off from 1970s levels of inflation. Now, the last thing we're gonna talk about is the Fed claiming that they're going to raise rates if they see a larger than expected increase in inflation. And I think this is really the only thing the Fed can do that's left at this point, because I think it's very unlikely that the Fed actually raises rates by any meaningful amount. Even Ray Dalio shares this opinion, saying that the Fed can't tighten without having a big negative effect on the markets. And this is clear as day. We saw this back in 2018 when the Fed tried to raise rates just up to 2% and the market started to implode. And the Fed did a complete 180 and said, all right, we're not going to be raising rates anymore. And so if they couldn't do it back in 2018, how would they be able to raise rates in 2021 when we have trillions of dollars more debt with interest that has to be serviced? There's no way that the Fed can actually raise interest rates to the degree that they're talking about. And so that's why I think this is the last thing the Fed can really do. I think the Fed's biggest weapon isn't actually raising rates. It's just claiming that they're going to raise rate. And I think it's pretty obvious at this point the Fed has backed themselves into a corner, and so they're going to keep saying, and they're going to keep making these claims that inflation is transitory, that we're going to raise rates if we have to. Well, in reality, it may turn out that neither of those actually end up happening, and then the economy would be in a tough spot. So this is just a quick video I wanted to make on my thoughts on what the Fed is doing and what they're claiming to be doing. In this video, I didn't really go into what I would do if we do see higher inflation, but I could make a video about what kind of companies and what kind of investments I would look at if we are entering into a decade of higher inflation. So if you want to see that type of video, leave a comment down below and I'll be sure to get that out to you. So those are really all the thoughts I have. Let me know down in the comments if you agree with me that the Fed is really backed into a corner and making these empty threats is really the only thing they can do, or if you think they really can raise interest rates to combat inflation, which may or may not be transitory. Like this video if you found some value out of it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next one.